Hey everybody, Jared of Second Life Design. A little bit of a different video tonight. First, I want to apologize about the road noise. I live on a busy street, so there's some traffic coming through. I had a mishap with my log trailer last week, and I bent it. I'm going to do a show kind of what happened, how I did it, how I'm going to fix it, I think. If anyone's a structural welder, fabricator, has any better ideas, please leave me a comment. Drop me a message, and I'd appreciate the help. Just kind of a unique situation, and I'm hoping I can fix it. It's not a major problem. I didn't pay very much for the trailer to begin with, so it's not a total loss. I have some budget to put into it, but still unfortunate, still what happened, and we'll kind of go from there. I'll show you kind of the carnage and what's left over, and we'll see what can be done about it. Okay, so here's what we got. This is my log trailer. I've done a lot of videos on it. Here it is. This side doesn't look so horrible. This side, you can kind of see it. It looks worse the further back you get. See the one leg kind of kicks off at an angle and goes up a little bit. It's pretty well bent. Generally, I don't know how thick this wall, I don't know the thickness of this tubing. It's gonna be probably 1/4 inch. I'm gonna cut one of the end caps off so I can see it, see what it's gonna take. But generally, pipe is pretty strong in my experience. It's resistant to bending and flexing and all that, so I was being a bonehead and didn't think about this, and that's why it broke. That's what happened. I was loading two logs at the same time, and they were both, I backed over them, and they were both under the frame rail, and they were wider than the frames. I thought I could just pull them through. There was enough room. They would have snuck through had they rolled together right. They didn't. They got lodged into the frame, and literally the pulling from the winch, the logs were stuck and it bent it right before at the weak point, kind of at the pivot point. If you kind of get a sense of that. So it just kind of started to taco this whole thing over, and that's why it bent. I was just pulling too hard. I had done similar operations before and just didn't get as lucky this time. So that's what happens, and hopefully we can fix it and move on. I knew there would be some bending just by the nature of the trailer. There is no cross members. I mean, it's essentially one big hoop here and then one hoop there. That's all that's keeping this thing straight. So there's not a lot to it. Let me walk around the other side, get a better idea of it. You can see her from here. It's pretty well bent. The little square tube under here, that's what my lights are going under. Those wires are ran through for the lights. And that piece is still straight. It broke the weld. It was holding that, eighth inch thick wall, tube steel. It was welded over there holding the lights. It broke that right off. I mean, it was pulling pretty damn hard. I think I kind of forget how strong this winch is, how much forces are at play, and running it through a snatch block like it is, it's just got a lot of leverage and something's gonna give. So my current plan, my current thought, I've thought about over the weekend, being this is just tube steel, what my plan is, I want to cut it apart on both sides. I use the tape to indicate where the bend starts and stops. So in between the tape is where the bend is. I've taken a long level and run it across here. It's all really good straight pieces here. This side is worse than that side. That's why it's a little bit closer. If both sides were like that one, I would probably just leave it and just kind of, that's what it is, and we'll just leave it. This side's pretty well dickered up, so we're gonna repair this correctly. I'm not thinking this is repairing it. I'm thinking of it, I'm gonna strengthen this and make it better and perform better as it is. You can kind of see the proportions of this thing, and this will go into my thinking of why I'm gonna repair it the way I am. It's really long out this front end and really short back here. There's not a lot hanging behind the axle. And in turn, what that causes is a lot of tongue weight also on the trailer, or on the truck rather. So my immediate thinking is, this is about 8 inches right here, give or take. I want to cut that out. Cut these cross members or these supports, these struts out. I'll still retain the structure, just cut them loose from the tube. Cut this all the way across. Sleeve this, wherever the cut is, go 1.5 feet either direction. So get a 3-foot piece of steel to go inside that. And then plug weld that inside. So it'll go 18 inches on either side of the seam, weld the seam itself, and in turn my trailer will be 8 inches shorter, which should put a little more weight towards the back, a little less tongue weight on the truck, and might just make it perform overall better. This thing is kind of a bear to back up, just because it's so, the proportions are kind of off. You can't really guess where it's at. It's just kind of squirrely, just because it's so long towards the rear. Getting all the weight over the tires would be the goal. Generally, when I'm moving something, I try and load it that way anyway, but when it's really long, it has to go forward, when it could go back and it wouldn't be a problem. So yeah, that's my current theory, is the rest of it straight, just kind of cut off the bent sections, cut it even, so it'll just be shortening the chassis by, you know, the 8 inches right here, and re-weld these struts on and call it good. I don't know if that's the best plan. That's my current plan right now. I'm probably done picking up logs for the year. I've got enough to suit me as is. I've got plenty of other work to do, so I've got some time to think about this, get some other input for some other people. I'm in no means a structural welder. I've done a lot of fabrication, just from being a mechanic for so long. I've done a fair amount of that, but I don't know if this is the best way or not. The sleeving, it seems to be the strongest, kind of adding bulk, making sure it's straight, cutting out the damaged sections, and taking out the weak point. It bent right here for a reason. This is the weak point. All of this is good, solid structure. So if we make this super heavy through here, where it's double-walled, and I don't do any more bonehead moves, this should make this plenty strong to where it'll never happen again. I wasn't lifting anything heavy. I was just using it incorrectly. I moved a 3.5-ton log with this thing, no problem. I was picking up two logs when I damaged it that weighed, you know, combined 3,000 pounds. So it wasn't a weight thing, it was me using it incorrectly. So take this as an opportunity to learn, improve it, and move forward. I don't want to get rambling on too long here, but that's my current plan. If you have any welding experience, any fabrication experience, practical experience, I would appreciate any usable comments, better ideas. Right now, the current plan is to sleeve it, plug weld the tube in, and weld the seam. That's my current plan. If you have something else to contribute that would be useful, if I'm doing that totally wrong, drop me a comment on here, send me a comment on Instagram at Second Life Design. I would really appreciate it. I want to get this, repair this correctly. This trailer is sweet. It works exactly as I need. I just need to get back in service on the cheap. I can't really afford to put a lot in this, because everything about the tree thing is all just about keeping costs down. So I got to kind of be smart about how I repair this and do it quickly and efficiently. So drop me a comment on here. Hit the like button. Hit the subscribe button. I really appreciate it. Follow me on Instagram at Second Life Design. Thank you.